Right now, in your body and mind, the nervous system is busy performing operations. The autonomic nervous system keeps us breathing and our hearts beating as we digest a recent meal or start getting a sense of when it might be time for exercise or time for bed. Meanwhile, the central nervous system is forming and recalling memories and filtering activity from our sensory organs, moving the spotlight of attention onto whichever seems the most interesting. In order to coordinate all of this activity, the nervous system has internal clocks, meaning systemic oscillations at different frequencies that work with each other to determine the state of the organism at any moment. This coordinated activity helps to link nerve spike patterns that might, for example, represent a melody and a memory that goes with that song. The slowest oscillating frequencies are in the delta and theta band, slower than 8 cycles per second. This band dominates the nervous system when we are asleep. The alpha and beta bands are between 8 and 30 cycles per second, roughly. They dominate when we are awake and moving at a just right pace. Music listening is shown to amplify activity in the beta band, which feels good to our bodies. The gamma band is the fastest oscillation. When we are moving or thinking at top speed, this fast oscillation rules. Oscillatory activity helps to control the timing of our speech and our music performance skills, including singing. This same activity keeps track of musical beats, including where the strong and weak beats fall, to connect these individual beats into larger chunks of a metric system. Most music has a steady tempo, meaning that it's easy for an oscillating system like ours to find and lock to a pulse. This is why most popular music is in the tempo range of 100 to 120 beats per minute, and why a 4/4 time signature is called common time. Human bodies like to move at this pace, amplifying beta band oscillatory activity and making it easy to synchronize our two arms and two legs to the rhythm. Did you know that monkeys can't dance, but members of the parrot family can? The ability to dance depends on thick, bidirectional neural connectivity between the auditory and motor cortex, which monkeys and apes lack. Humans have these, and so do the very few species who are vocal learners, meaning animals that have the vocal muscles to mimic the sounds they hear. Parrots, minor birds, and cockatoos have this, and they can also extract a rhythm from music and lock their bodies in sync with it, dancing on the beat. It works like this. First, you hear a song with a strong and steady metrical beat. An internal clock recognizes the sound of the regular pulse and tells the motor system. The motor system takes charge of predicting when the next beat will arrive. It feeds this information back to the auditory system, essentially telling it, "I'll let you know when a measure or 8 have gone by so that you can direct your attention to other things in between beats or sections." Because 4/4 time and 8-bar sections are so common, this neat trick lets our minds wander during the middle of sections, swinging back around to pay close attention near the end of a verse or the end of a chorus. The motor system also informs muscles in our voice and limbs when to expect the next beat. This lets us move our fingers in time to arrive at a key on the beat, or our hands to come together at the moment that the snare arrives. Rhythm perception is something that nearly all humans do automatically, without any training. Persons with beat deafness can keep time to a metronome, but cannot extract a rhythm from music. This shows us that beat deafness is similar to dyslexia, in that neural oscillations are impaired in their ability to coordinate words with sentences or individual beats with metrical organization. In the next video, you'll learn more about the thick neural pathways and how they turn sound into music.